We've said that there are two ways of looking at the shape of a structure. There's the electronic geometry, and now there is the molecular geometry. The molecular geometry is the more complex way of looking at it. But the thing is, it's the more accurate way of describing what's happening. Now, we're going to say that molecular geometry treats lone pairs and surrounding elements as different. So remember, here's the key. Our central element is A. The surrounding elements around that central element are X, and then the lone pairs on the central element are E. So if we look at this made up compound AX3 up top with the lone pair, we'd say that A is the central element. It's connected to three surrounding elements. And it has one lone pair on the central element. So that would be E1. Now, technically, it's around four groups. So we go here to the four group section. And we look, AX3E1 will be classified as trigonal pyramidal. So there's a lot more shapes to remember now because of this. But again, remember, the molecular geometry is the more accurate way of describing the shape. Because what we should realize is, this lone pairs, think of them as a raging fire or something that's out of control. Something like that would need a lot of room for itself. What's happening here is because we have these non-bonding electrons, they're going to need as much room as possible because they're just pure energy. So what they do is they push away the other guys. They compress the bonds of those other guys. So the lone pair is more to itself on one end of the compound. This causes us to have a different shape. The molecular geometry is a great way of explaining how that shape looks. Pyramidal, you can see that this right here kind of looks like a pyramid. So that's why they call it trigonal pyramidal. Now, if we go through this, if you have two groups, here this is AX2, there's no lone pairs around the central element, same thing here. For three groups, you could be AX3, where you have no lone pairs, or AX2E1. Here SN is in the center, it has two surrounding elements, those would be the X, and it has one lone pair, so that would be E1. This shape can come in three different names. They all mean the same thing. So be careful. Your professor could say bent, angular, or V-shaped. Every single one means the same exact thing. If we have four groups around the central element, we could have AX4, where it has no lone pairs. We could have AX3E1, or we could have AX2E2. And again, AX2E2 is just like AX2E1. It would be classified as bent, angular, or V-shaped. If you have five groups around your central element, then it goes really crazy with the number of shapes that you could have. Here, AX5 would mean that the central element has no lone pairs around it. AX4E1 would be seen as seesaw. And another way we could have drawn this is we could have drawn a seesaw like this. You may see it like that as well. AX3E2 is T-shaped, and you can see that this looks like a T. That's why they call it T-shaped. Here, AX2E3 is actually linear. It's just like the AX2 up here. It's linear as well. All the lone pairs decide to orient themselves in this way, kind of forming like a triangle. And then the surrounding elements on either side. Then if you're AX6, well, if you have six groups, you can be AX6, where you're octahedral. If you have one lone pair, you're AX4E1, and your name is square pyramidal. And then you could be AX4E2, and there you would be square planar, kind of shaped like a square. So again, the molecular geometry, even though it's more of a pain, it's a more accurate way of describing the real shape of these compounds. They're basically telling us how do the lone pairs influence the shape of our molecular compound. The lone pairs are like pure energy. They're pushing all the other bonds away from them. This actually gives them weird looking shapes where the names come into play. So there's more memorizing here than with electronic geometry. But if you can memorize this entire page, it's okay. It'll be just like memorizing electronic geometry. Because we know electronic geometry, AX2 is linear, AX3 is trigonal planar, AX4 is tetrahedral, AX5 is trigonal bipyramidal, and AX6 is octahedral. I would recommend just memorizing this page here, because that way you can take out molecular geometry and electronic geometry all at the same time. But remember, there's a distinction. Electronic geometry treats lone pairs and surrounding elements as the same, as just X. Molecular treats them as different. We have X for surrounding elements, and we have E for lone pairs.